Hello, I'm Stefan Faroux. I specialize in database application performance, and I'm going to tell you the basics of Oracle Performance Monitoring. Oracle is heavily instrumented. I assume you know the architecture of Oracle. If not, watch my short video on the topic. There is a very large collection of pseudo-views known as dynamic views or vdollar views, the name of which starts with the vdollar, and that are, for the most part, Oracle internal state variables and counters that are presented as if they were views and can be queried with SQL. Most counters are cumulative counters that are reset whenever the database is restarted. With cumulative counters, you must work by difference. You must have a before and an after pictures, a bit like all these ads that you see everywhere. A long time ago, Oracle introduced two scripts, bstat and istat, both later prefixed with UTL for utility. Bstat copies the current values of vdollar views to tables and is run before a period of interest. At the end of the period, istat is run, it computes the differences between the current values and those that were saved, and it generates a report. Later, Oracle introduced statspac, which is indeed a package, the most important procedure of which is called snap. The way it works is that you run snap at regular intervals, and it takes snapshots of the dynamic views. Typically, statspack.snap will run a series of insert select statements into performance history tables. There is a snag. All vdollar views don't directly map memory structures. They are already pretty elaborate and are built on top of row views. Many vdollar views are joins, some are aggregates, and a select star may be a costlier operation than with a plentiple. You also save the values, and writing to a database costs more than reading from it. What happens is that taking snapshots actually increases the load. As you often take snapshots because you have performance issues, you don't really want to make things worse. The frequency cannot be high. Typically, you take snapshots every 30 minutes to 2 hours, so as to keep overhead to a minimum. Three issues remain. Issue number one is that statistics about the execution of a query are updated when the query terminates. If you have a query of death that is bringing the server to its knees and that out of despair the system administrator kills the process before you can probe in memory, for instance by querying vdollar session long apps, there is some collateral damage. A significant part of forensic evidence disappears. It will make problem solving harder. Issue number two is that if things are so bad that everything looks almost frozen, querying the dynamic views will be as bad as querying anything else. It happens rarely, but it may happen. Issue number three is that when you take a snapshot, memory can be full of innocent-looking queries buzzing along. Then, queries that are no longer executed may be replaced by new queries, some of which may be nasty, but disappear before you take the next snapshot, when everything looks again nice and peaceful. Some counters will tell you that something bad occurred in the interval, but it will be hard to find out what. Let me tell you that your real problem is that queries aren't reused, which you have several ways to spot. Will you increase the snap rate? Well, it will push overhead up. Besides, a snapshot every 10 minutes may be bearable, but a lot usually happens in 10 minutes, and you certainly cannot take a snapshot every tenth of a second. This is why some third-party vendors came with monitors that are running on database servers, which attach to the SGA in read-only mode and read counters directly without issuing SQL queries and without saving values inside the database each time. It much lowers the overhead and allows to monitor the memory at a much higher frequency. With version 10, Oracle shipped an improved stats pack in an offer called Performance Pack. The two major components are a new monitor called ASH for active session history and a revamped stats pack called AWR for automatic workload repository. By default, ASH probes memory every second and only checks active sessions. Data is saved to memory buffer and dumped to the database only once in a while. In the meantime, AWR takes stats pack style snapshots every hour by default. All great and good, except that the performance pack is separately licensed and that you have to pay for it. If your boss looks like this, great, don't look for another job and go for the performance pack. If this is a more familiar figure, don't despair. Stats pack is still available and supported, and you can actually do a lot with it. Many DBAs did a great job for years with no other tool, and there are a couple of free internet resources that allow you to make an even greater job with it. Unfortunately, Stats Pack has completely disappeared from the recent documentation, most probably by mistake. I'm going to fill the gaps in the doc and show you how to install Stats Pack on a small test database running Oracle 11, Release 2.